Last month, we celebrated our sixth-year reunion, and we declared ourselves the fittest little county in the USA. This remarkable journey started 8 years ago when I got up one morning, stepped on the scale as I usually did, naked because I didn't want to add any jewelry or underwear to add extra weight. I stepped on the scale and it broke. And with it, it took my system of pretending that I wasn't overweight. I wasn't just pudgy, I was fat. So I decided to get fit, and from that, the meltdown eventually occurred. Now, I hadn't been honest with the Department of Motor Vehicles for about 40 years. I'd lied about my weight. My husband didn't even know my weight. But this time, I decided I was going to do something about it. But I wasn't just going to focus on weight. I was going to get fit, and I would follow three principles, F-I-T. I'd make it fun. I'd find fun foods that I love to eat that wouldn't pack on pounds. I'd find fun exercise that I love to do that I would do even if I weren't trying to lose weight, and one that I could sustain for the rest of my life. I would do what was right for me. I would individualize the program. I had a torn hamstring at the time, so I had to be really careful about what I did. And maybe most importantly of all, I would team up with other people. I would do it together. I wouldn't try and do it alone. I offered to chronicle my experience in the local newspaper. And each week they reported my measurements, my weight, and whatever exercise I had tackled for the week. I tried Pilates, yoga, kickboxing, spinning, jogging, tennis. I tried every exercise I could imagine because I was on a mission to find the one that worked really well for me, one that I could enjoy and that I would do no matter what for the rest of my life. After doing this for a little while, I offered to lead teach a little workshop on how to lose weight and get fit. I didn't expect much of a turnout because, after all, it was going to be winter and we have a lot of seniors that don't like to drive at night, certainly not in snow, and we have a lot of families that have to put their kids to bed because there's school the next day. So I wasn't expecting much of a turnout. Imagine my surprise when over 1,000 people showed up on the first night of what later became the Nevada County Meltdown. On the first night, we organized everybody into a team. We had incredible teams that were created. Sometimes they were neighbors who'd come together. Sometimes they were strangers that formed teams. But we had wonderful teams that developed. Each week we grew, and we ended up with over 200 teams. And we lost nearly 4 tons in 8 weeks. And we demonstrated how much weight that was when on the last night we drove in a school bus that weighs about 4 tons. Filled with school bus drivers, the Durham Dolls that made up a wonderful team, and we celebrated our success on this last evening. Well, could we take what we've learned and make it available to other communities? Would other communities follow our example? To make sure that happened, I wrote a book, From Fat to Fit, Turn Yourself into a Weapon of Mass Reduction. I also wrote a manual that detailed all the steps that we went through to create our own event. Since the Nevada County Meltdown occurred, over 300 communities have followed our example and have organized in one way or another their own weight loss event. In addition, I've given dozens of interviews, if not hundreds, and encouraged individuals and communities throughout the United States, even internationally, to undertake their own weight loss challenges. But I'm even more excited about how we can share this program with other communities throughout the nation.
Mirrors everywhere, but nothing good to see. I thought for the longest time that this was just my destiny. One day decided this ain't who I wanna be. So it's to the gym I go to face the body facing me. Objects in the mirror will get thinner than they now appear. Don't like what I'm seeing, yeah, but that's the reason I come here. And if I come most every day, I know those pounds will disappear. Objects in the mirror. Yeah. back on my mind. Walked in, saw those mirrors. Well, I almost died of fright. But now I come most every day, and much to my delight. In that mirror, in the weight room, now I see a different sight.